Secretary of State Hillary Clinton and Treasury Secretary Tim Geithner arrive in China just in time for tensions between the two most powerful economies in the world to ramp up. Reason one is Chinese dissident Chen Guangcheng, who after apparently brokering a deal between the State Department and China to stay in his homeland, now wants to apply for asylum in the US. And China decided it's the perfect time to send in some more surveillance ships off the coast of the disputed Scarborough Shoal in the South China Sea, escalating tensions with the Philippines. The shocking death of All-Pro and future Hall of Famer Junior Seau has the NFL world talking. The 43-year-old star linebacker was found dead in his home Wednesday from an apparent self-inflicted gunshot wound to the chest. Seau is the third former NFL player to take his life this year and has everyone talking about the possible effects of concussions on players. In October 2010, Seau survived a 100-foot plunge down a seaside cliff only hours after he was arrested for domestic violence charges. One of Edward Munch's The Scream paintings, sold at Sotheby's last night and fetched a record $120 million for an auction painting. The man holding his head under a blood-red sky is a modern symbol of human anxiety and the only one of four copies the master painted, which is still in private hands. And finally, some pop poopage for you. Pepsi is making money off the late, great Michael Jackson. Classy. Putting an iconic pose of him on their cans with a whiz-bang way to share and buy music and make your life better whilst your taste buds dance. Released bin Laden letters say he was peeved at Taliban strikes on too many Muslim brothers and not enough Western targets. Also suggestions that he was jealous of some up-and-coming and, of course, better-looking terrorist dudes. I smell drama, potential soap opera, and maybe Pepsi can sponsor that one.